Shitij, please tell me about yourself.
Hello, I am Shitij Gupta. I am from SGTB Khalsa College, Delhi University. I secured second rank in Botany DU Entrance 2019 in general category.
What about the preparation? When did you start the preparation for this entrance?
I started my preparation back in January 2018. I joined an institute called Grassroots. I have great faculty here, and my college faculty is also good in the core subjects of botany. Like, I'm from botany, so that is also a beneficial thing for me. So they actually polishes your applied skills in here in coaching. They actually enhance your biochemistry, molecular biology, and actually I used to hate molecular biology, but now I'm able to do it. Actually, I'm able to do it. Then you have here a great faculty for biochemistry, plant physiology, cell biology and cell physiology, and all those features. So it's actually totally on you. You should join if you feel that you are not good in applied or a classical subject. You have classical subjects also there.
Shitij, how did you prepare for the examination?
I started with analyzing the previous year questions. Previous year question papers, basically. So you should, if you analyze them, you can see there are more of the classical portion as compared to applied or modern portion. In the classical portion, there is majorly biodiversity, which consists of your like algae. In algae, you should study life cycles in algae, their habitat and their reproductive forms. And next portion is fungi. Fungi is the major portion which comes in every in botany entrances. Actually, they you get 5 to 6 questions from fungi. From every phylum, you get 1 or 2 questions. Then next is your archegonids, which contains your Bryo, Pterido, and Gymno. Which all in all, these three comes in 5 to 6 questions, and which metum is the most important in gymnosperm. Then you have your angiosperm taxonomy, which in taxonomy you majorly get questions from phylogenetic relationships like monophyly, paraphyly, and homology, homoplasy. There are certain terms in taxonomy, like you can see those terms in the plant systematics by Gurcharan Singh. It's one of the good book for taxonomy. And then you have anatomy, plant anatomy. In plant anatomy, you generally get questions from anomalous structure, like in bignonia, anomalous secondary growth, and chinopodium. In this 2019 paper, there is a question from chinopodium. And then you have embryology. Embryology is actually, you can say, is a science of exception. There are various exceptions in embryology, and every time 1 or 2 exceptions came in the exam. And then you have majorly applied portion contains the classical portion is this only. Then you have applied portion. In applied portion, you have the plant physiology. Majorly, they ask questions from phytohormones, photosynthesis, and respiration. Then you have molecular biology. In molecular biology, they don't go in much detail or much conceptual question from them in botany entrances. So they have major questions are PCR primer questions, and coding strand, antisense, sense strand. And in genetics, you got questions from crosses, you have monohybrid, trihybrid. You have pedigree analysis questions. Generally, one question from pedigree generally came in every exam. Then you have economic botany. Economic botany in classical portion. From economic botany, you get progenitor questions from cereal grains. And economic botany, you can get some more questions from Vavilov's work. It's not so common, but then you have applied portions like this only. That's all.
What about the families here?
Taxonomic families, you can say they are just 1 or 2 questions. So I just recommend, if you can, you should do it, but don't spend much time on them in cramming those family characteristics and all. Major family you should know, Liliaceae, Poaceae, Ericaceae, and you have Asteraceae, one of the advanced, Amborella, Magnolia. These are the most primitive plants you should know. You should know about the classification system, Bentham, Hooker, Engler, Plantel. They are the major portions.
The merits and demerits and the salient features of the systems.
But sir, I don't think you should spend more time on them. You should actually revise more of steel. Yeah, I was forgot that steeler system and steeler revolution. You always get 1 or 2 questions from them.
Pteridophytes.
Yeah.
The pteridophyte steels. And what about the economic importance, you know, like fungi, algae, bryo?
Economic importance, you can get one or two questions. Like I said, in fungi, you can get 5 or 6 questions. One of them was IR. Generally from either Aspergillus niger, citric acid production and all.
And what about the Puccinia? You know, Puccinia is very important in fungi. So do you get questions from the Puccinia cycle? Because it is a big cycle, so many stages over there.
Yes, you can get a question like in sequence of those stages like teliospore, uridiospore and asiospores, like these kind of questions, in what sequence, which one of them is the dicaryophase. And from Puccinia, you also get the question from absence of dolipore septum, I suppose, in this.
So that is a feature of acidiomycetes.
That is a feature, but it's an anomaly in Puccinia.
Huh.
One of these things, I think dolipore septum or clamp connection is absent, I suppose.
Yes. And what about Ustilago?
Ustilago is actually, it's not in Delhi University syllabus now, so they just don't ask it much. But you should know about what is loose smut, what is covered smut, and what is their causal organism.
Okay. So that means there's one thing which is very clear. In Delhi University, what is taught in the undergraduation?
Yeah.
That is your first year, second year, and third year. So that is the pattern that they follow in MSc.
Yeah, they follow that. But you should see, like, I recommend you should see the old syllabus, which was before CBCS. Like, anomalous structures was not in this portion.
Shitij, what are your future plans?
I would like to clear CSIR net and go for the research in India first. Then I'll see to it if I want to go abroad or not. If I'm getting a great faculty or great research facilities in India, so I have no issues in staying in India. Otherwise, I'm planning for abroad.
And any message for the students?
Just study and have fun with that. Don't study at all times. Sara time mat padte rehna.